only bandits creep around in the dark without a light. Where's your torch? Hey, you. It's forbidden to walk at night.
Do you seriously think you can creep around here in the dark right under my nose? That's against the law. Well, you won't forget this in a hurry, because it'll take a nice pile of coin to fix it.
Enough. What impertinence is this? Do you really want me to lose my temper?
But I was just... You misunderstood me. Sorry. You can go.
Thank you. Good day to you.
Let's have a word about the price.
All right, so.
What do you say to this?
I'd almost shake on that. Almost. All right, so.
Yeah! Yeah.
I've got something for you. I know this is your favourite.
It is indeed. Thank you. Wouldn't you like to take a stroll somewhere?
I'd love to. Henry, do you think sometimes about how it was in Scarlet?
How do you mean?
Back then, before everything. When I was taking care of the hens at the mill, taking Sammy his lunch at the mines.
It seems like a lifetime ago, doesn't it?
In the summer, I always took my shoes off and walked barefoot the whole way. And when it was really hot, I'd stop at the stream and stick my feet in the water for a while.
I had to make do with the tub in the yard when I was helping Pa in the forge. You know how hot it gets there in the summer? I always sneaked off if I could, even though I knew Pa would tan my hide when he came home.
I remember that. He was always looking for you all over the village, but you'd be hiding somewhere with Fritz and Matthew. Me and the other girls used to follow you secretly, but we never told your Pa where you were. And when he gave up looking for you, the three of you would go off to the woods to beat each other with sticks.
Yeah, we were playing at being knights. Jesus, I used to get black and blue from it. I can still feel some of the blows that big ox Fritz landed on me.
No more playing at nights. Now you're practically a real one.
Nah, I'm no knight.
You are, though. As chivalrous as they come. You saved my life.
Well, if you want to look at it that way, then you're a knight, too. After all, you saved my life.
Henry, a girl can't be a knight.
But she can save lives just as well.
Oh, who wouldn't save a little lamb like you? Here we are. Thanks for stopping by, Henry.
My pleasure.
God save you. What can I do for you?
Thank you.
I'd like to discuss the price.
All right, sir.
What do you say to this?
You're a right pinch purse.
Agree?
I'd almost shake on that. Almost.
I knew we'd come to an arrangement.
God save. How may I help you, good knight?
I'd like to make use of the bathhouse's services.
So what are you interested in?
I'll certainly need a physician to treat my wounds. Then a hot bath and laundering my clothes.
As you wish. Do you have the coin?
I'm not giving you that much.
And how much are you willing to pay?
Are we agreed?
That's not enough.
You won't regret spending the money. I guarantee it. God bless.
Yeah. 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 Yeah! Yeah.
Greetings. What business have you?
I've returned from Mehoyed, sir.
How does it look there?
I brought them help from the monastery. Brother Nicodemus and Johanka from Skalitz. Fortunately, Nicodemus was able to cure the disease. At least what he's doing looked promising so far.
Thank Christ. Some good news for a change. What about the captive? Did you question him?
He was infected too.
I see. Did he survive?
Fortunately, he survived, and I had a chance to question him.
What did you find out?
He was transporting the false coins to Pribislavitz. He got them from some merchant called Menhart.
I don't know him.
Neither do I. But I know where the money's handed over. It's not far from Rovna, and this Menhart should be waiting there about now.
Excellent, Henry. We mustn't let this opportunity slip through our fingers. You go there and put pressure on this Menhart to tell us what he knows. Don't go yet. There's something I'd like to talk to you about. Good luck, man.
You haven't disappointed me. Nothing against Bernard, Robard, or any of those others. But none of them could find out as much as you. At least not without beatings and torture. And that doesn't always work. You're a godsend, lad.
Thank you, sir.
Now go and find out who's behind everything, and then we'll deal with them.
Yes, sir. Sir.
What is it?
Sometimes I ask myself what it all means. Why does God allow such things to happen? All this slaughter and revenge. Over and over.
It's a hard question. I'm no theologian. But long ago I came to the conclusion that the only thing that makes sense is that it's all a trial. Life is one long series of problems to solve. The more you solve, the better a man you become.
Never thought about it that way.
Well, just look at the pampered ones who have no concerns in life, like young Lord Capon, for instance. I shudder to think how he will rule when his time comes. Tribulations spawn in life over and over again. We must stand our ground and face them. So, I go to Sasso and solve this one. Hmm?
You can rely on me, sir.
Good luck, son.
God save you, good knight. And what can I do for you?
How are the Talmberg folk getting on? Is it peaceful here?
Do you even have to ask?
Some poachers have settled in the woods near the inn. A right band of them too. The master huntsman's at his wit's end with them. And maybe he could use your help.
How are the Talmberg folk?
Ah, things here. Goodbye.
Thank you. Yeah! Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.